Hey, what's up, guys? This is Fula with another video. Shout out to the whole LDGC. So, in this video, before I go into the boxing videos that I'm gonna do, I wanted to just talk about an issue that, you know, I have been looking at and been wondering, like, wow, what priorities are these people about, you know, who have positions of authorities. So it appears that there's going to be a government shutdown, and that government shutdown has to do with the wall being built, the proposed wall being built. Now, the thing I wonder is, you know, you're trying to get a budget for a wall, right? But why not get a budget for something to, quote unquote, keep the immigrants from coming in drones to the country, if you guys are so concerned by immigrants? And when I say that, I don't mean a wall. I mean a new foreign policy. A new foreign policy that will ensure that countries such as, you know, Guatemala, countries such as El Salvador, countries such as Honduras, countries such as Venezuela, countries like these, countries like Nicaragua, these kind of countries will have supreme sovereignty over their land, that they will have supreme autonomy to do what they want and to do what will be beneficial for the people and not be beneficial for the interests of the United States. Why not spend money on something like that? Or why not spend money on reforming some of the things here, you know, because there's many things that need to be reformed over here. Some of the things I definitely see is the education, the public education system, you know. I just don't get, like, why you would spend money, why you would shut the government down for a wall, whereas you can shut the government down for something way, way more moral, way more beneficial for society. A wall is not beneficial for society. A wall means just more money coming out of the pockets of people. And for me, as an immigrant from Africa, as an African immigrant, I just see it as a sign of a fascist regime, basically. I mean, this country can preach all about democracy. This country can preach all about freedom. This country can preach all about equality. This country can preach all about freedom of choice and whatnot. But building a wall kind of tells me that you don't want people to have freedom of choice. For the simple fact that you're basically doing something very authoritarian, you know. This is like an authoritarian maneuver. And to take steps further, you have Americans who are actually, who started a GoFundMe account. A GoFundMe account, right? The goal is $1 billion, okay? They've raised $15,761,000 for this thing, okay? Already. out of 1.0 billion, and it's only been six days since this thing has been up, okay? The crazy thing about this whole situation is people are willing 258,826 people are willing to donate this kind of money in 6 days. If this money was donated to something like a reform in school systems, a reform in the health system, do you not realize how much, like, change the society would be? Like, the society would be changed for the better, actually. But no, people want to spend money on a wall that they probably won't even see, okay? They want to spend money on a wall that really doesn't benefit them at all. Because I have my thoughts about it, that thing is being built to keep people in. You know, that's just my theory. I'm not going to go into much detail about it. But this just really shows the fabric of this country, man. And, you know, I experienced it. And I just stay quiet about it because I have a goal. I have a focus. But at the end of the day, man, for what I know, from what I know and what I see and what I experience being in the community, us immigrants mind our own business, man. We don't get into anybody else's business, okay? We mind our own. We have a goal in mind. All we're trying to do for the most part is provide for our families, save money to send to our families and things of that nature. You know, we to be honest, we don't even give a care about like trying to be accepted, you know. I mean, at the end of the day, some of us go to the deep end and try to, like, integrate ourselves to be, you know, with the in crowd, be with the how should I say, the American, what's a good word, with American pop culture and all of that stuff. But most of us, man, we chilling. We just want to build, we just want to do what we do without hurting anybody, you know. It's a very small minority of immigrants who come over here and cause trouble. A very, 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 very small minority. In fact, I will bank to say that more Americans who are homegrown cause trouble than immigrants do, you know. But they'll never tell you those statistics, you know. And the fact of the matter is, there's a bigger agenda, you know. So this money, this 15 million that they already raised in 6 days. Yeah, like, so what I'm wondering is, it's easy to raise 15 million in 6 days, right? But reforming, let's just say reforming, like, the healthcare system here is difficult. You don't want to shut down the government for something like that. You don't want to shut down the government for reforming the education system, but you want to shut down the government for not building a wall? Like, get the hell out of here, man. Like, this guy, you know, I'm sorry to say it, man, but, you know, when you have a certain ideology that you go by, you're blinded. You become blinded. And when you have this nationalist ideology, you're going to be blinded, man. And you're going to just do things out of emotion. And that's bad when you do things out of emotion, because you're not thinking properly. You know, and that's what this dude is doing. And that's what these people are doing. These idiots who donated $15 million, they're doing it out of emotion. I don't think there's no logic in it. You know, but me, like, you know, this is further proof for me that this place, America, right here, this is just a transit point, basically. This is just a transit point to do things that you need to do to, like, get yourself established and move on and just go, and just, like, basically get ready to go back home so you can, like, build back home. And then if you want, like, maybe have a place out here where you, like, occasionally go to relax, chill, and whatnot. That's the purpose right there, man. It's just like, at least my purpose is to, like, have something where I'm building back home, right, and making a change there, but also having a place where you can just relax here, let your hair down, and leave it at that. But, you know, the fabric of this culture, man, is showing me that it's not good, man. It's not good. Because when you have people actually funding this and stuff, when you have 258,826 people funding something like this, this just shows me that, you know, what people like Martin Luther, what people like Malcolm X, what people like that fought for, it didn't really make no headway here. You know, it really didn't at all. Yeah, I'm not looking for anybody to, and that's the thing about me, I'm not looking for anybody to, like, change the order of the day here, because, like, in order for, like, anywhere in the world, in order for revolution to take place, in order for concrete change in society to take place, it all starts with individual change. But I think because of, like, entertainment, I think because of just different factors, that Americans will not do that, you know. They won't do individual change because they're used to certain things that could change the society. They're not going to do it, because even in Europe, I have a cousin living in France, and individual change led to communal change, and now you have the whole country, like, up in revolt because of they're not happy with their wages, you know. And you even have policemen up in revolt because of their wages. So when you have people that are designed or that are employed to keep the order of the order and peace also revolting, then you know things are hitting the fan. And you know who's to say that the French military may be next? And that affects a national thing, international thing, because we know that the French military is all over Africa. What if they just decide, you know what, F this, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm you're gonna have to pay me more. Then where does that leave the French, you know? I'm just saying. But, you know, most people don't want to man up and do something like that. You know, that's the thing. So we have these outlets like social media that can get our voice across. And maybe some like-minded people will hear the voice and be like, yeah, you know, what can we do? And that's all I have about that issue, man. But I just find it confusing, like, why people will fund a wall being built, but people won't fund, like, a better education system, or people won't fund a better healthcare, or people won't fund a better, like even mortgage or real estate system that will keep you from, you know, falling by the wayside, you know, keep you from debt piling up. But that's neither here nor there. Leave your thoughts, leave your comments, let me know what you think. Let me know what you think about the wall. Let me know if you think a government shutdown is necessary for the wall. And that's all I got for now, guys. Good job on you.